Are you on? Hello students, my name is Amandeep Singh Bhui. I am working as assistant professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering in Amritsar College of Engineering and Technology, Amritsar. In today's video, we will be demonstrating you about the second practical, that is the troubleshooting in the cooling system of an automobile. If we talk of the cooling system, the main parts of the cooling system are the, if you can see here in this block diagram, you can see the first is your the radiator, and then after that at behind the radiator there is this radiator fan is there that is used to cool down the hot water that is coming through the engine. At the bottom there is this bottom hose pipe. From this the cold coolant and water mixture goes into this pump here. This pump then circulates this cold liquid into the engine. This is your engine. In the engine there are internal passages made inside the engine through which this cold water, or these are the jackets, water jackets that are made inside the engine during casting. Through this, this cold coolant circulates, and during this circulation it absorbs the heat that is being produced during combustion, and then this hot liquid goes back through this system into the upper hose pipe, and then it goes back into the radiator. In the radiator you can see that there are these series of pipes are there. Through these pipes this hot liquid, it circulates, it moves, and with the help of this fan and the atmospheric air, this hot coolant gets cooled down, and at the bottom this cooled water and coolant mixture is then again circulated back into the pump through the engine, and this whole process repeats itself. If you see here, this is the model of this cooling system. This is your actual radiator. In this radiator you can see these these are the various these pipes are there through which the coolant gets circulated. In this radiator you can see that on top this is the your filter cap is there. This filter cap is used to maintain the required pressure of the coolant inside this whole system. This is your upper hose pipe, and the lower hose pipe fits in here. This is your cooling fan. This is electrically operated cooling fan. When the temperature of the coolant reaches a certain temperature, this fan automatically starts operating, and using the forced circulation, this hot coolant gets cooled down through this radiator system. Okay. Now, the main purpose of this practical is to diagnose or troubleshoot the various problems that can be faced in the cooling system of an automobile. Okay. The first problem, the main problem that is faced, is the overheating of the engine. The overheating of the engine is indicated in your car's dashboard. There is an indicator that tells you the temperature or the heat or the temperature of the engine. If it is this indicator is moving up towards the, it has two levels, that is C and H. Okay. If your indicator is moving more towards H, this means your engine is overheating. Now, this overheating can be caused by a couple of reasons are there. One reason is the loss of the coolant. Okay. Now, this loss of the coolant can be internal or external. Okay. In the external part, if we see, the coolant can be lost from this, if you see here, this filter cap is there. So, if the filter cap is not properly tightened, what happens is the pressure loss takes place, and from that pressure loss the coolant might leak through the passage, through this gap, and go into the atmosphere. Okay. Or if I remove this pressure cap, you can see that there will be a rubber sealing there, that if the rubber sealing is also damaged, then also leakage takes place. Second leakage that can take place is through these pipes. If these pipes get rusty, so what happens is because of that rust, the pipe gets damaged and the coolant might leak down onto the car floor or into the floor. And another problem that can be there is the problem with the hose pipes. The hose pipes might have worn out. There might be cracks inside the hose pipes. Through those cracks, the coolant might leak. Now this external leakage can be detected. You can physically see that leakage on the floor. You can see the green liquid. If that green liquid is on the floor, this means there is some leakage that is taking place from this cooling system. So you can check all these parts of the cooling system for any external leakages. If there is any leakage, you can replace that part, or you can do the desired repair. Second type of leakage that can be internal leakage, that is inside the engine. Now if I come onto this actual engine here, so you can see that on this side here, this is the actual engine of a Maruti 800. This is, we have dismantled here. This is the inlet where the inlet hose pipe for the coolant is attached, and through these you can see there these two holes. These are the holes for the exhaust. And these two holes in between, this is for the coolant exit. The hot coolant comes out from this part. Now if I, this is the engine head, and this is your engine block is there. If I remove this engine head, so we can see that there are these internal passages, you can see. These passages are made for water circulation. Now this engine head and engine block, these are sealed by using a gasket. A sealed gasket is there. Now if there is overheating of the engine is taking place, this means that the either the coolant is not being circulated properly, or there is some leakage of the coolant is taking place. Because of that, what happens is the internal temperature of this engine increases. Due to that, what happens is there is a damage to the gasket takes place due to that heating. And because of that damage to the gasket, the internal leakage of this coolant into the combustion chamber might take place. And this leakage that also damages the engine. If the engine overheats above a certain temperature, then the seizure of the engine might take place. So that leakage might be because of there are some cracks inside the engine block, or there might be that the gasket has been damaged. So in that case, the appropriate troubleshooting we have to do to detect the cause of this leakage. And the next problem can be in the faulty pump is also there. If the pump is faulty, this means that pump is not, the water pump is not circulating the coolant properly through this cooling system. So we have to check for the working of the water pump also. If the pump is damaged or it is faulty, then we have to replace the pump. Next is your the problem might be in the thermostat also. The thermostat normally operates at about 88 degrees centigrade. When the temperature of the coolant reaches 88 degrees centigrade, the thermostat automatically opens and the hot water is circulated back into the radiator. There might be a problem in the working of the thermostat. If the thermostat is not working properly, the circulation of water it stops through this cooling system, and that also increases the temperature of the engine. So that is all in this practical here. Thank you.